that is low cloud in the area of Buckingham Palace. If the cloud was clear a little bit, we would be able to see a little bit more. We'd like to thank the air traffic controllers at London Heathrow Airport, who have really bent over backwards to try and make it possible for us to get just some pictures. And the guys from Castle Air have done an absolutely marvellous job for us. The weather has been quite appalling. Anyone else to say hello to? Oh, that chap's still on his motorbike over there in Manchester. What about any of the other regions? Anybody else we ought to finish off with? I've certainly got plenty of dedications. Doc Campbell, hi to you. Ship's company and crew of HMS Challenger. They're on North Humberside. They're watching. They'd like to say Merry Christmas to everybody. And all the staff and patients at Birmingham Children's Hospital, especially Rita. And she says special greetings to everybody in BCH. And indeed, a very happy Christmas and get well soon to everyone who is watching this show from a hospital. And I particularly would like to say hello to a hospital I know very well, the Princess Margaret Hospital in Swindon. And hi to everybody who works there. Our heli telly has moved round to Big Ben once again. You can see the time as we rapidly run out of time on this fabulous Christmas day. It's a great day for me, I must admit, a great opportunity to present live television on two continents. It's the very first time it's ever been done, and I hope that everybody in Australia has watched and enjoyed the show very much indeed. We've got an enormous crowd in Sydney. There they are. Live pictures from Sydney, giving you some idea of how much this show has meant to people in Australia who have got friends in the United Kingdom, in ERA, and throughout the continent. I've had an absolutely marvellous time. In Melbourne, we once again wish very best of luck to everyone associated with the England cricket team, most of whom have quite rightly gone off to bed. I hope that you have an immaculate Christmas day. I wish you well and have a wonderful time. Bye-bye from all of us here. Happy Christmas.
Television premiere this Christmas Day on BBC One. Annie, the musical.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us.
What do we say, Annie?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Why any kid would want to be an orphan is beyond me.
This afternoon on BBC One. And you have about 35 minutes to tune yourself up for another kind of music, if you're going to BBC One's Top of the Pops Christmas party. But before that, let's not hang about, because now every second counts. Every second counts, Paul Daniels.
it's all about time. We don't want to waste it, because as one famous Greek writer said, the happier the time, the more quickly it passes. Of course, he said it in Greek, but you wouldn't have understood that. Let's meet the contestants.
And our first Every Second Counts couple tonight, Paul, are Jeannie and Eric Birch from Abbey Wood in London.
Jeannie, hi Eric. Hi Jean, makes it into a clean show. Tell me all about Eric.
Eric's my husband.
He's a good memory. Good memory. He did that straight in, got it right, yes.
He's the Betty shop manager.
What's the odds on you winning tonight then, Eric?
About 50 to 1,
I think. 50 to 1 on or against?
Oh, against.
Against, I see, yeah. And how long have you been married to him?
5 years.
Five years?
Yeah.
Yeah? Got any family or
no.
Pets or?
Got two badgies.
Two badgies.
One of them's pink.
I think I've been budgie.
Well, we called him Alfie, yeah. And then we went on holiday and my mum looked after him. And I phoned her up in the air. She said, Alfie's laid 2 eggs.
Tell me about this strange